Praise the Lord, hallelujah. Blessed be the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ in this wonderful and blessed morning. Dear children of God, let us together on this year of 2021, on this November 13th Saturday morning, to worship our God, to praise our God, our Heavenly Father, for every wonderful opportunity. With thankfulness from our heart, let us worship and praise Him. Let us lift a hand and tell Him, thank you, Father, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, Lord, thank you. Tell Him, thank you, tell Him, thank you, tell Him, thank you. Hallelujah, Father, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Last full moon, our Lord protected us. Lift your hand and tell Him, thank you, Father, for protecting us last morning. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Father. Thank you. Last night, He gave us a good sleep. For that, lift your hand and tell Him, thank you, Father, for the good sleep You gave us last night. Thank you, thank you, thank you. With good health, happiness, this morning, our Father who woke us up, tell Him, thank you. Lift your hand and tell Him, thank you. Thank you, Father. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. This morning, victoriously, our Lord who is leading us, for His mercy and grace, tell Him, thank you, Father. Thank you. This morning, victoriously, the Lord who is leading us, for His mercy and grace, Father, tell you, thank you, thank you, thank you. For His mercies, tell Him, thank you. The Psalms 103 says, bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless His holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all His benefits. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all His benefits. Verse number 3. What all is His, what He's done for us, who forgives all your iniquities, who heals all our diseases, who redeems our life from destruction, who crowns us with loving kindness and tender mercies. Hallelujah. Our Lord delivered us from iniquities. He healed all our disease. He redeemed our life from destruction. Hallelujah. Remember His mercies and loving kindness and tell Him thank you. Tell Him, Father, thank you, for You forgive all my iniquities. Thank You for healing me from all my disease. Thank You for redeeming my life from destruction. And finally, thank You for crowning me with Your loving kindness and Your tender mercies. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We did not wear it, but the Lord crowned us. And verse number 8 says, the Lord is merciful and gracious, slow to anger and abounding in mercies. As a father pities his children, so the Lord pities those who fear Him. This morning, hallelujah, the Lord who has got pity upon us and the one who leads us, let us lift a hand and tell Him thank you. Hallelujah. Father, thank you, thank you, thank you. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, for this morning we tell You thank you. Last night and last morning, Father, for leading us wonderfully, thank you. For the good sleep You gave us last night, thank you. With good health, for waking us up, thank you. This morning, Lord Jesus, for leading us wonderfully and victoriously this morning, we tell You thank you. Father, we pray for all who are hearing this voice today. In the name of Jesus, we bless and pray for them. Let their family life be blessed. The children You have given, let them be blessed. Their workplace, let it be blessed. The way of living, let it be blessed. Father, in everything, for Your children to be blessed and to be a blessing, help us, Lord, help us. Cover everyone under Your wings. Father, let Your angels surround them and be a fire of wall around them. Father, this morning, whatever challenge Your children are facing, Father, to overcome that, Your grace, in the name of Jesus, let it prevail by the mighty power of the Holy Spirit. Let it be upon Your children. Let Your favor be revealed at the workplace. Let Your favor be revealed in their business. Thank You, for You are a God of miracle. Thank You, for You are a God who is more than enough in any situation. Father, You are more than enough. By Your grace, fill Your children, we pray. Father, especially who is sick hearing this voice, in the name of Jesus, let them be healed. Thank You, for You are a great physician over every kind of sickness and disease. Especially if you are sick anyway, lay your hand over there and let us pray. Heavenly Father, those who have laid the hand where they are sick, Father, let Your presence prevail over there. Heal them, Lord. Every spirit of sickness, we rebuke you. In the name of Jesus, for the complete deliverance and healing, thank You for giving it to Your children. Those who are having a problem in their family life, let them come back. Those who are going through mental depression, let them come out of it. Lord Jesus, in Your name, hallelujah, every mental distress, that which is bringing it, that which is bringing behavioral changes, evil spirit, we rebuke You. In the name of Jesus, Father, thank you for your miracle. Fill your children with your grace. Those who have got a pain in the lower end of the spinal cord, which is radiating towards the leg, where they cannot sit, where they cannot walk. Those who are suffering this morning, you who have the authority over heaven and earth, in the name of Jesus, be healed. Thank you for the complete deliverance. Hallelujah, Father, thank you. Lord Jesus, this coming Tuesday, Wednesday and Thursday, the fasting prayer, we give it into thy hand. Let it be greatly glorious. Fill your children with your grace and mercy. In Jesus' mighty and matchless name, we make this prayer. Amen, amen, and amen. Let the Lord bless you all abundantly this morning. Let the grace, the peace, the joy of the Lord increase in your life in abundance and overflow through you, I pray. Today further, we are going to meditate from the book of John, chapter 15, verse number 9. John 15, 9. As the Father loved me, I also have loved you. Abide in my love. When we ask many of them, they say, I don't get enough love. There is no one to love me. In reality, I don't have anyone. Many of them say, husband does not love, wife does not love, children does not have love. There are many cases that we know. And we hear literally every day and almost every time. So over here, as you and me, as the children of God, Jesus Christ is saying, as how the Father loved Jesus Christ, in that same manner, Jesus Christ loves us. And then he's saying, abide in my love. So the Lord is saying, hallelujah, when Jesus was in this world, how Father loved Jesus, took care of him. In all his need, he was there and loved him. Hallelujah. In that same manner, I also have loved you. Jesus Christ is giving his word to us. I also have loved you. Not a normal, ordinary I love you that we say to one another, but genuinely, the owner of the universe, the creator of the universe, I also have loved you. Hallelujah. And then he's saying, continue in my love, abide in my love, in this love, continue in it, or in this love, abide in it. Hallelujah. A place where you abide is called a place of refuge. Hallelujah. So Jesus Christ has told you and me to abide in a place where it is filled with his love. So where should we live today? Live in the love of Jesus Christ. We can ask to ourselves, how do I abide in his love? How can I stay in his love? I will tell that to you immediately. Hallelujah. When you receive Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, hallelujah, probably you might be born in a Christian family, but when you confess with your mouth that Jesus Christ is my Lord, hallelujah, when you confess with your mouth that Jesus Christ is your Lord, you are becoming the children of God. And then the next thing that what you have to do is being obedient to the word of God. What Jesus Christ says. Jesus Christ said, love one another. A new commandment I give to you. In 1 John 3 it says, verse 23. And this is his commandment, that we should believe on the name of his son Jesus Christ. That is what it says. That confess his name and then love one another. Loving us to one another, to love one another. Not to keep hatred inside of you, not to keep revenge inside of you, not to speak against one another. But how Jesus loved us. Hallelujah. In that same way, love one another. And 1 John 3, 24 says, now he who keeps his commandments abides in him and he in him. Hallelujah. By this we know that he abides in us by the Spirit whom he has given us. So two things, to know and to be abiding in his love. First of all, confess Jesus Christ as your personal Savior. And secondly, love one another. And when you do like that, you're abiding in his love. That is why it says in the book of Ephesians, what you have to wear, what you have to know is the depth of Christ's love inside of you. Allow that passeth all understanding. Hallelujah. Know its depth, know its height, know its weight. Then only can we lead victoriously. This morning, as you hear this voice today, understand very well that I am being loved by Jesus Christ. I am being loved by Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. In the book of Romans it says, I am being loved by Jesus Christ. Even without honoring his own son, he gave him for us, dedicating or showing his love for us. So how can we enjoy his love, meditate his love? Hallelujah. Meditate the love that he showed upon you. Read Romans 8. Read Ephesians 3, the second part of it. Hallelujah. Over here, all it says, the greatness of his love. In Romans 8, it says, hallelujah, he loved us by giving his only one begotten son. He gave it unto us and he loved us. Hallelujah. Not that we loved him, but God loved us. Hallelujah. So the love Jesus had towards us, just meditate that. If we say or put that in simple words, because of his love towards us, Jesus came into this world. Even if none of us were there in this world and only you were there, Jesus Christ would have come to this world seeking me. In that same manner, if only you were there in this world and no one else, he would have come for you. What great love is his? It is that love that made him to go on the cross of Calvary. It is that love, hallelujah, which made him to be nailed on the cross. It is that love that gave him to sacrifice his love, life for you and for me. Isn't this love? If he did not have love, can he do it? Jesus said, no one can take my life from me, but I give myself unto us. Hallelujah. When Jesus was in the garden, when the soldiers came to catch him, and when Jesus asked, whom do you seek? They said, Jesus. And when Jesus came forward and said, that is me, and even all the soldiers heard, they fell down. No one can catch Jesus. Jesus gave himself to them for your love. Hallelujah. Because he loved you and me, he gave himself for us. Isn't this love? Isn't that love we saw on the cross? Isn't that love that made him to be a public mockery? Child of God. Hallelujah. If there is love, we can do anything. Hallelujah. The display of that love for you and for me was a death on the cross. And Jesus Christ, who loved us in this manner, when you meditate his love, we can abide in his love. We don't think it is easy to preach, but just think of the love of Jesus Christ, an eternal love, an unchanging love. When situation come, when climates change, when circumstance come, his love does not change. The love of Jesus is an eternal love. So this morning, lift your hand and say, I am a person loved by Jesus Christ. Say that again. I am a person loved by Jesus Christ. Say your name and say, I am loved by Jesus Christ. And if you are a person loved by Jesus Christ, then why should you be worried? Why should you be depressed? Why should you go down? Why should unnecessary thoughts come into your mind? You are a person loved by Jesus Christ. And when you say you're loved by Jesus Christ, means you're loved by God. God is for you. To stand against you, nothing can come. So this morning, meditate his love. Hallelujah. Meditate the love of God. Forget everything. Don't meditate your problem. Don't meditate your sickness. Don't meditate your medical report. Don't meditate the loan in your bank. Don't meditate your difficulties. But meditate the love of God that he has towards you. And when you do that, you will abide in his love and nothing can destroy you. When you understand that love, your fear will go. When you understand that love, you will be bold. When you understand that love, hallelujah, for you, you will enjoy peace, joy and happiness. So this morning, the Holy Spirit is reminding us that love meditated. Then only can you abide in his love. And with these words, let the Lord bless you. Hallelujah. If you can understand this love, send this message to others also. Let them also come into this love. Do not forget, please pray for this coming 3 days fasting also. In the name of Jesus, we will grow, we will increase, and we will multiply. We are blessed. We are really blessed. We are highly blessed and highly favored. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you today. Hallelujah.